So the other day, my friend and I were making a review for Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, and then this came up.
How is it that this movie, this plot, where I'm supposed to feel bad, where they make me shed a tear for talking CGI character, how is this more touching than a plot where somebody's dying from cancer?
Yeah, I know. I knew you were going to say that.
Tell me that, Dario. Why?
I tell you why. Two things, the writing and the directing. Oh, look, they're both done by James Gunn.
No. Now, I was kind of joking, but I also meant it when I said that I care more for this CGI character than a real human being on screen that's dealing with something horrible like cancer. But like my friend Dario pointed out, it goes back to the writing. And man, good writing really makes a difference. And I don't think you have to be a film expert to be able to tell when the writing in a film is good or not.
I think good writing is important in a movie because as the creator, you want to bring people to the same level of love and care you have for your story and characters while also trying to be dynamic. But you have to do your best to translate that in a way that brings them on the same journey you were on, creating this entire world from scratch. It's like any relationship. You don't just take someone's word that it'll work out. You have to experience a bit of easy and hard parts of life with that person in order to develop any sort of feelings to come to a satisfying conclusion. It's also more interesting to see someone struggle to achieve a goal rather than just beat the game on easy mode. Like when Thanos had to fight the Avengers in order to get at least one stone, or when Sherlock Holmes made a mistake trying to stop Moriarty's bombing, or when Naru had to stop the Predator from destroying her village while being hilariously outmatched as a basic human hunter. I think one of the best examples of overall writing is from the movie Warrior. Basically, it's about two brothers who grew apart at a young age due to their abusive father, who all eventually have to cross paths again when a mixed martial arts tournament promises the winner a huge cash prize. It's a simple plot, but what makes it interesting is the dynamics in everyone's motivations. One brother needs the money to pay off debt before losing the house with his wife's disapproval of fighting, and the other brother is trying to give money to his dead military friend's family to be able to keep them afloat ever since of his passing. Plus, the dad has sobered up and is wanting to reconnect with his sons that find him unforgivable, all in the meantime attending this tournament that will eventually pit them all against each other. And I'm telling you, guaranteed tears by the end of it. Please give it a watch. All in all, movies are supposed to be emotional roller coasters, and the best roller coasters, or at least the ones you remember, are the ones that make you say, "Let's do that again."
All this talking about writing actually reminded me of what's happening in real life with the writers. At the time of this recording, the writers have been on strike for about 2 weeks. I'm not gonna go into details about what the writers are demanding and why the studios are refusing some of their demands. Actually, Dan Morrell made a really good video where he goes in depth, so I would really suggest checking his video. While doing research for this video, I learned that the last time that the writers went on strike was in 2007, and some movies really took a hit from the lack of writers. So I really hope that the writers and the studios can reach an agreement so they can get back to making amazing stories like the ones where even a talking CGI raccoon can steal your heart. Alright, and that's all I have. Thank you so much to the guys, George and Dario. You can catch us over at the Slate Media channel for the Slate Podcast, where we review movies. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe to this channel. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.